Kong Marcoleta, may lumabas po na balita na ang susunod na aksyon na gagawin daw ng kabal diyan sa Kongreso ay it will be against Kong Marcoleta. So dahil ang purpose nito ay dahil dun sa ginawa niya kay VP Inday na pagdi-defend. Saan ka nakakita, di ba? For me, bakit may post? For me, it just goes to show na itong may mga kabal dyan, may mga kongresista dyan who are, how do you call this? They don't care about the national interest. They don't even care about showing, how do you call this? Showing courtesy to a fellow lawmaker. Hindi. They are driven by motivations far more base and ridiculous and possibly criminal. Yuan says, no one deserves to be oppressed, lalo na sa pagtindig sa tamang katwiran. An attack on Kadante would be an attack on every INC member. His voice represents ours. I hope not. Suzaku says, tsaalang muna ako, nahahigh blood ako sa kabangag. City Hunter Gaming says, kung malaki ang budget sa ayuda, meaning niyan, wala talagang klarong plano ang administrasyon ni BBN para paunlarin ang Pilipinas. Yes, matagal na po namin sinabi yan. Kapag ganyang kalaki ang ayuda, it means, so let's say the ayuda is, sabi, 500 billion lang. Pero meron din po silang kinuha dun sa unprogrammed funds daw na 300 billion. So let's say 800 billion ng ayuda. That's 800 billion that did not go into roads, bridges, healthcare, that did not go into developmental projects, that did not go into the Maharlika Fund, assuming that we even agree with that. That's another problem. That did not go into PhilHealth, that did not go into our SSS, that did not help senior citizens in the long term. Nothing in that ayuda is developmental. Nothing in that ayuda gives us anything for the future. And nothing in that ayuda lowered the prices of food. Ulitin ko. Concern natin, presyo ng pagkain, tubig, kuryente, internet, transportation. Pero, what has it done so far? Nothing. It has either gone into the pockets of the not very principled government officials, and only a percentage of that is actually distributed. Right? So, that's 800 billion that did not go to any development projects, did not go into public service, did not go into healthcare, did not diminish the prices of food, electricity, water, transportation, did not improve our internet, and so on. Now, I would like to address Atlol. Sabi ni Pineapple, kung alam niyo po yan, ba't di niyo sampahan ng kaso? Pineapple, number one, may karapatan kami magsalita at magpahayag na ginagarantiya ng Article 3 ng Saligang Batas. Look it up. It's called freedom of speech. Number two, yes, alam ko ito because I'm better than you at alam din ng mga followers dito because they actually study and they listen. Okay. Bakit di kami nagsasampa ng kaso? Number one, ang nagsasampa ng kaso, aralin mo kasi bago ka magsalita. Ang nagsasampa ng kaso, yung aggrieved party. Ngayon, there are instances na pwede tayong mag-raise ng mga issues for the purpose of spurring on an investigation to see if things actually have gone wrong and who is responsible for that. Number two, we can attack policies without actually filing any cases. Bakit? This is what we call a petition for redress of grievances. Pwede kaming mag-rally, pwede kaming magsalita, pwede kaming magpahayag, pwede kaming magsulat, pwede kaming mag-rant on social media because there is more than just one way of correcting things. It is not just through the judicial system, but actually through the pressure, political pressure created by this right. Okay? We can pressure our officials. Bakit mo gustong i-burden yung hukuman with things like this when we can raise our voices and guarantee to these public officials that they are never going to see the light of Congress ever again? Why would you complain about the kind of methods that we use when these methods are not just guaranteed by the Constitution but are protected by it? Ngayon, pineapple, sabihin mo dun sa handler mo, palpak yung ano yung kanil yung inyong operations. You don't deserve the taxpayers' money that they're paying you for these kinds of ano, for these kinds of comments. Ang chip nyo na nga, and you are, no matter how small the bayad is for you, it's too big. Sabi ni Nenita, sabi nga po ni Kong Marcoleta, paano daw kung i-ask niya yung COA na audit din daw lahat ng disallowance ng mga congressman? I'm sure that might be one of the reasons why they're plotting against him now. What if mag-resign si VP at tumakbo ng senador? Anong opinion niyo? Wala akong opinion dyan. That's up to her. Bakit ko yung si second guess si VP Inday sa ganyan? Kung sa tingin niya, merong strategy behind that, hindi ko pa nakikita what that strategy would be. So, ako hindi. I will accept whatever she thinks is best for her and the country. So, kung sa tingin niya, she will be better serving us as senator, full support ako dyan. I may not even agree with the strategy, assuming that there is such a one, then, but I will fully respect that. She's in a better position to say whether or not she is, this is the best course for her. Sabi ni Anton, huhulihin ba siya if he's not guilty? Yes po, a warrant of arrest is issued for the purpose of bringing a suspect or an accused to the jurisdiction of the court. Mayroong arrest for purposes of trial, and then there is an arrest if the person is at large and is going to be serving a sentence. So, wag po kayong nakos. This is something that must be made absolutely clear to everybody. Ah. Not all arrests mean that you're guilty. Only the arrests to serve a penalty. Yung arrest to bring you to the jurisdiction of a court does not imply guilt. In fact, kaya siya dinadala sa court so that it is determined whether he is guilty or not. Anton, ha? He's brought to the jurisdiction of the court. Not because he is already guilty. Because yes, he can ask that. Why not? Pwede ba tayo mag-petition to open the books ng HOR sa public? I don't see why not. Sabi ni, 358 million birthday gift ni BBM sa hospital bill ng mga pasyente, garapalan na talaga. Burn says, pwede po ba i-fast forward ang video ni BBM pag... Kasi isang word, 10 hours bago mabigkas eh. Grabe. I thought I was mean. Sabi ni Maris, mas lalo si Stella Hermes. Wow, oh, social. May Hermes siya. Tanong lang po, in case i-require with finality ang OVP na i-return yung final amount sa NOD, saan po kukunin ng OVP yung amount na ibabalik? TY. It doesn't matter. The law doesn't state. Basta kailangan isoli yun. So, either personal mo. Kung nagastos mo na yan, personal. Ganun po yun. But, and I've seen government agencies do that. Sabi ni Jam, pwede pa naman daw i-defend ni VP yung budget niya for the third deliberations. Yeah, but I don't think she'll show. Mia Miranda says, yun po bang freedom of information? Act no longer in effect, wala pong act na freedom of information, hindi siya na-pass. Meron lang FOI na policy si former President Duterte in relation to the executive department, but not to any other. So, dahil hindi, and it was by executive order, and this current president is no longer applying it. Sabi ni Je, pwede po ba ang resource person isubmit na lang ang sarili niya sa court for contempt? Sa court? Wala pong jurisdiction ng court sa kanya before umattend sa mga hearing. Total, lahat ng pinapakontempt pag hindi gusto ang sagot. Oo, totoo. I understand why you're saying that. Yes. Porkilicious says, unethical yung comment ni Kong Abante kay Attorney Roque na ikukulong daw sa Women's Correctional. Nagtawanan yung mga crocodile sa sinabi nila. I agree. If it wasn't inside Congress, that would be a violation of the Safe Spaces Act. Interviewin nyo kaya si ano, si Senator Risa. Diba? Senator Risa Hontiveros, ano pong masasabi nyo tungkol dito sa sinabi ni Congressman Abante? Palibasa, may immunity for what they say and do in during an inquiry. So, hindi siya makakasuhan criminally for that. Gayunpaman, we should call him out. He says, masaya yan pag si Kong Marcoleta ang ginalaw nila. Totoo yan. Sabi ni Romel, bakit tahimik ang bias media? Tinatanong pa ba yung mga ganyan? Sabi ni Celino File, ang Abante na yan, feeling niya talaga may ambag siya. Huwag na pabalikin sa... I love how do you call this? How brutally frank you can be.